it's Kim Kesty here in the Creative Classroom at Spellbinders, and I'm super excited to be really starting out with the basics with our new Better Press system. We're going to talk you through all the parts and pieces and run our very first print through step by step with you. So let's get started. We've got the Better Press system kind of laid out here, and just as a reminder, I wanted to show you that the three shims that do come in your system when we do the original unboxing are just going to go on the bottom of the chase here. You're just going to pop them right in there. And again, we did these shims, so in case you later on down the line choose to use a much thicker paper, you have the option of taking one of these shims out. Next, I'm going to put my magnetic insert here, and that's going to fit perfectly inside our chase. You can see that I've used mine a few times already, and I've got a little bit of ink on it. Totally normal, guys. When you first unpack your Better Press, take a good look, because it will probably never look that pristine again as it is when you unbox. So common, totally common to have a few little ink spots on it. We're going to do a separate video on how to clean both the Better Press system and the plates, so don't worry about that. You will see that the platen, which is this clear piece right here, does have the registration marks on it, which is awesome. So when we go to put our card panel on, we have both the A2 size, which is kind of traditional American size card, and then also an A7, which would be a 5x7 card. So we have the registration marks for both of those, both on the platen and on the magnetic insert, as you can see here, the A2 and the A7. So just keep in mind that those are going to work together to create a beautiful, beautiful press print with you. They are magnetized on here. So again, a review, it does have these really cool little magnets on springs that are going to allow the paper to stay away from the ink until we're ready. So I'll go ahead and take that back off. And the first thing you want to do is go ahead and grab one of the different varieties of cotton card panels that are in your kit. And by varieties, I mean we have some bisque panels, some pebble panels, and some porcelain panels, which would probably be closest to regular weight. So I'm going to go ahead and grab one of those. Again, this is the porcelain panel. And before I get started inking or placing my Better Press plate on my magnetic insert, I'm going to go ahead and tape this cotton card panel to my platen. I love that we're using some of these traditional old terms, you know, from good old printing press days back in the day. Now this is a little small roll of our Best Ever Craft Tape, which of course you can order more rolls and up your stock on that, but you just need a small little piece, and I'm putting it kind of in the corner of this cotton paper. You don't have to push super hard, but you do want to line it up with these grid marks for the A2 size. We do sell the cotton card panels also in 5x7 pre-cut, so that's really cool for those of you who like the bigger size cards. So now that I've got my cotton panel in place, I can go ahead and put my press plate onto my magnetic platform. Now I have the one originally, as it shows that it came in out of the box, but I do have one that I already have open. So I'm just gonna kinda switch that over. I'll leave this one pretty for my photography studio. But you will see that these plates are a little bit different. We're gonna have a totally separate video really talking about why these are different and what different things you can do with them. But the first thing you'll notice right away is they're not your classic Spellbinders color of plate. We did that on purpose. These are a different color plate because they are for a different use. So this is our Better Press plate. Beautiful, beautiful detail in these guys too. I think you're absolutely gonna love it. And because this is magnetic, I can kind of fuss around with how I want my pretty flower bouquet to look. Maybe I want to angle it this way. You know, you can kind of just play around and get it exactly how you want it to look. And then same for the sentiment. I'll grab my sentiment. I think I want it kind of down in this corner. So I can use these smaller grid lines here, of course, to line it up just perfectly until I'm really happy with it. And then if anything tends to move while you're inking it, you can always double check and make sure that everything's perfectly straight before you go to put it into your die cutting machine. So I also have the third magic formula piece, and that is our Better Press ink. So again, it's always the paper, the plate, and the ink that work together to create a beautiful, beautiful print. So I'm going to grab this Better Press ink, and it's a great size ink holder. It's not too small, not too large, fits perfectly in my hand. And then I'm just going to apply the ink to the metal plate here, and it does kind of remind me a little bit of stamping in that we're going to, you know, ink this guy up. Now, normally if you put ink on any kind of metal, you would expect it to kind of pool up or bubble or do some funny things, but that's not the case with this Better Press because it has a special coating on this plate that allows it to beautifully accept the ink in a nice, even manner. Make sure my sentiment's all pretty there. And the ink is does have that kind of wet look, so if you tilted it to the light as you're trying this at home, you can kind of see exactly where the ink is laid on. So that's an easy way to tell. Pop the lid back on. And now my press plate is inked. It's ready to go. I can go ahead and turn over the platen and gently pop it on top. And that satisfying little magnetic noise is going to happen. And that means it's all set and ready to go. The one thing I'm going to make sure is that I don't push down on this at all until I bring it to my die cutting machine. So you will need a compatible die cutting machine to do Better Press. We, of course, recommend one of our Platinum machines. This happens to be the Platinum 6. Works perfectly with it. Think of the Better Press system as being a tool. It's going to combine with your die cutting machine, and this is going to create the pressure to give you that perfect letter press look. So I just pop it on the platform here. I'll move it over a little bit more. And then as I kind of use the handle to guide through, again, I don't want to push down on the platen. This actually is quite a bit easier even than die cutting as far as the pressure. It probably feels a little bit similar to our Glimmer hot foil system. It's going to feel familiar. You just go ahead and bring the chase right through, and you don't need to run it through twice or anything like that. And then just by lifting up the magnetic little pins right here, you flip that guy over and you have a beautiful, stunning Better Press print. This guy has pushed that ink right into the paper. I think you can even see really nicely on the sentiment there. Look how beautiful and deeply debossed that is. So now I've got that ink into that cotton paper in just a really beautiful fashion. And now I'll be ready to take this panel off. You just gently can peel this tape back. You can even reuse it for another project later. And then release your cotton card panel. And you are all set to do a variety of things. You can add some color to it. You can simply add a few little embellishments, maybe some gems. Pop that on a card base and you have a stunning finished project. So I hope you saw how perfectly easy that was to create a Better Press print. I know that you will be diving into your starter kit and also adding some additional Better Press plates. We have some stunning designs available here at Spellbinders. So check them all out. Try your first print. I know you will have fun, and we will see you in the next video.